friends, and welcome to day 8 of the Scraptember and 30 Days of Sketches collaboration. Here's the sketch that we're going to be working on today, and the prompt is to use something that you have hoarded. So I am going to be using some of my much hoarded basic gray collection. I miss them so much. And also the adhesive that I've hoarded, as well as some embellishments that I have hoarded as well. So I'm just going to go ahead and back my photos with some black cardstock, because there are going to be a lot of colorful strips down that left side. So I wanted the pictures to be able to stand out. And so I really love this paper from Basic Gray, and I thought that it would make really great strips. So I'm just cutting some of them out. I don't have a lot of pink and red in my photos, and so I'm trying to stay a little more neutral and use cooler colors. So for the most part, I'm going to keep it to kind of the blues and greens and yellows. And originally I thought I was going to use some of the stickers from Creative Imagination, which has been in my stash literally for years, decades maybe, but I don't end up using that. So I'm just kind of layering out these strips, and I went ahead and tore them on each edge. I really like that little torn look, and I'm just going to be kind of layering them down just to see what works best here. I wanted to make sure that I was changing up the colors and the size of the strips and just getting a good variety here to kind of draw your eye down. I wanted to make sure that I was repeating those colors as well. And as I was doing that, I realized that I did not have enough strips. And so I went ahead and cut a few more, again, leaving the more pink and red strips aside. So I'm just kind of going down here, and once I get these placed, then I'm actually just going to pull them all right back up again, because I am going to add some washi tape into them, and I really just wanted to make sure that I had enough strips. So once I did that, then I'm just adding a little bit of adhesive and layering them up and down. I don't really have a big preference, other than I don't want the same colors right next to each other, and I don't want the same size right next to each other. And so I'm just sort of leaving a little bit of space and making sure that I'm getting a fairly even color. And so that one little tiny strip actually got there by accident, because it landed there and I had some adhesive, and that's where it was. So I'm just going to finish that, and I apologize, I had pulled my layout down so that I could work on it, and I didn't realize that it was out of the view of the camera. So I'm going to pull that back up here in a minute, and I am just now putting on those washi tape strips. Again, I was trying to stay fairly neutral with it, but these are also an item in my stash that I've hoarded for quite a while. I don't know about you guys, but I definitely have my fair share of washi tape, and so I was glad to be able to use up just a little bit of it. And so now I'm just going to get rid of all those scraps. And I will tell you guys, I was feeling really bad about getting rid of paper scraps, and that was definitely something I was hoarding as well, and it was just kind of getting unmanageable. And so I think I had seen on somebody's video that they were putting them into recycling, and so I actually have a trash bag and a recycling bag now that I use, and I feel a little bit better about letting go of some of those strips of paper. So I did use this little die cut. These are pictures of my husband and I in front of Expedition Everest in Animal Kingdom, and that is just a die cut that I had designed and cut out with my Pazel InView, which is the die cutting system that I use. And I had these banners from Basic Gray, and I can understand why this is the only one that Basic Gray ever came out with, at least to my knowledge, because they're sewn into the paper and they're kind of a pain in the butt to get off of the paper. But I persevered and I managed to get it done, and I really wanted this border because Expedition Everest is based in the Asia part of Animal Kingdom, and there are a lot of banners kind of all over the place, and I thought it really worked out pretty well for that. And so I also wanted to add just a few flowers. I am kind of a flower nerd. I really like to add flowers to my layouts. I think it gives it a lot of visual interest, and I like to make the clusters. And so I just wanted to add a little bit more color because there's so much color down that left side that I wanted to make sure that I was adding in a little bit of color throughout the layout. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that. And I guess as far as hoarded items, that is also something that I have hoarded. I have hoarded flowers for many, many years, and I have them separated out into jars that I had gotten off Amazon by color. And it makes it super easy to pull out the kind that I want, and so it was worth the time to sort it. So now I am going to be using some wood veneer from Hip Kit Club. This is a newer product, and so it was kind of fun to get to use some of that up. And and there's a little word phrase, and so I was hoping that I could find more wood veneer, but I really just didn't find what I needed. So I just kind of went with those circular ones. So I am not going to do my entire title on camera because I really struggled with where I put it. So it is going to eventually go up top, as you can see here in the final layout. And there will be some close-ups coming up. Thanks again for stopping by. As with always, make sure that you're hopping along to the other participants in this hop. And if you could give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, that would make my whole day. So thanks again, guys, and I will see you tomorrow with another video. Bye-bye.